Good morning. I live in a van and this is what I did today.
Queenslander Cass Jovanovic is 22 and doing a solo lap of Australia in her own converted van.
If I was living in Brisbane, I would definitely be struggling paying rent. I'm lucky that I don't have to pay rent. I live off a budget of about $500 a week, which I don't really reach every week, which is good.
Cass, who's now in South Australia, has been on the road since January. But her dream began 2 years ago with a search for a suitable van to renovate.
I wanted it to be small enough to just blend in on the streets, and this van's very small and discreet, easy to drive, easy to park, close the curtains up and that's your camp spot. So I bought the van for $20,000 in January 2022, maybe $13,000 after all the accessories I added, so it was about $33,000 in total.
This $33,000 investment is now her full-time home.
My van just has the basics. It has a bed, a fridge, a sink and storage, so I have to use public bathrooms and shower facilities, which can be kind of hard to find in some areas.
But van life has given Cass a whole new perspective.
I just liked the chill lifestyle of like really taking it at your own pace, no pressure to be anywhere, go anywhere, just laying in the sun, going to the beach all day. That's kind of my vibe.
And it's a vibe that's attracting full-time workers as well.
Smile. We saw a video of van life and we just thought, oh, hey, that would be cool to do, dive deeper into it, and then Here we are.
Sydney-siders Kevin and Janice have just finished building their dream home, a luxury 7-metre van fitted with all the extras.
We both work full-time, so space to work was a big one.
Janice is a project manager in construction and Kevin, a finance broker. Both can work remotely, so instead of paying rising rent in the city, they've spent their money on converting a van.
We've been paying rent on a weekly basis just over $1,000, so we'll be saving just over $4,000 a month. Purchasing the van was around the $26,000 mark, and the conversion of it into a tiny home per se on wheels was around the $45,000 vicinity.
That's luxury on wheels for about $70,000. The cost to rent their house for just 1 year was more than $50,000.
Money well spent and money hard saved.
Our lease ends mid-June, so we've got 2 weeks to pack up the house, sell everything, move into the van and hit the road. So the countdown is on for sure.
Their new van has a toilet and shower, high-speed internet, solar power, even space for two sets of golf clubs.
So this is the selling pile here.
Yeah.
All right, done.
What about this? In the end, we decided to go with the spirit of van life, which is to be happy with less and just to be happy like in the outdoors. If and when we come back, we will like start again.
On the front line of this trend is van renovator Blake Sewip. What started as a hobby 5 years ago is now a burgeoning business called Vanology.
I'm seeing more and more people making the decision to sell their homes, buy a van, work out of it, and travel around Australia.
Blake converts around 8 vans a year. Kevin and Janice are two of his latest customers.
How's the van?
It's good.
Yeah.
Road tested everything.
We have 37,000 kilometres of coastline to explore in this country. That's more than a lifetime of beaches.
And according to Blake, it's single women who have become his biggest customer base.
They buy vans and they just travel around Australia. It's actually more than single men. I have a lot of couples and single women.
And for 22-year-old Cass, that means a year by herself on the road. Though she's the first to admit that van life does have its challenges.
It's not as glamorous as it looks online, that's for sure. My van is usually a lot messier, but I do very much enjoy the minimalistic lifestyle, but that can be hard as well. Like, I've had my sister and a few friends come visit me in the van and it gets very claustrophobic very quick.
Which, for Kevin and Janice, is a blessing.
The fact that we're together in a close space is actually better for us than to be separate. otherwise, yeah, it just feels empty when we're not together.
Sweet.
So it's definitely a bonus.
Now, don't take this the wrong way, Woody, but you strike me as someone who's lived in a van.
Oh,
No, but would
No, stop right there. No. What is it about this that screams van life?
I mean, you're a happy, free-going guy. I feel like you might have done it at some... Would you? Is this in your future?
It looks pretty good, actually, to be honest. Yeah. I don't know how my family would feel about me just leaving and cruising around Australia in a van, though. That's a hard sell.
Yeah. Well, Liz Ellis did it for a year. Yeah. And she packed up the kids, took them on the road, and she loved it. I would love to take my boys around Australia.
Could you do more than a year, though? So, like, I get the let's do it for a year, but to commit to live.
Not to live. I think that's probably too much.
You have to be Woody for that.